So I'm going to show you how to construct a line perpendicular to a given line. So first we need a line to start with. Just using my straight edge to draw that line, we'll call it line L. And now what we need is a point not on this line that we can draw a perpendicular through. And I'll just put a point here, call it point P. So the goal is, we want to draw a line perpendicular to this point P that goes through this line L. Okay, now it's all set up, we're going to use the compass as our measuring device. And you want to put the pointy part on point P. And then you want the pencil part to go beyond line L so that when you draw an arc, it's going to intersect this line L twice, like that. Make it a little darker. Okay, so you can see there are two points of intersection right here and right here. And I'll label those points A and B. All right, so what we just did with our compass is we measured the distance from point P to point A is the same as the distance from point P to point B. And by doing that, we're automatically creating a situation where this point P is going to have to lie on the perpendicular bisector of segment AB. Okay, now our next step, since P is on the perpendicular bisector, is we're just going to put the point on B and then draw an arc. Then put the point on A and draw an arc. And really what you're doing here is you're just doing the perpendicular bisector construction at this point. And in fact, you didn't even really need to make an arc up to point P. All you really need is this part of the arc down here for another point. And we'll call this point, Q. You already have this point P that you know lies on the perpendicular bisector, so all you need really is this second point that you can draw the line through. But I went ahead and drew these long arcs so you could really see how all you're doing is doing the perpendicular bisector once you create these points A and B and create segment AB and point P is on the perpendicular bisector of that segment. So here's P and Q, and now just going to draw that line through points P and Q that both have to lie on the perpendicular bisector. And again, the reason why points P and Q lie on the perpendicular bisector is they are both equidistant from points A and B. Okay, so this line PQ, I can name it that way, or I could call it line M if I wanted to. So line M is the perpendicular bisector of segment AB, but it's also, just generically, a perpendicular to line L. And the fact that segment AB lies on line L and line M is a perpendicular bisector of the segment is just part of the construction. But really my goal in the construction was simply to make a perpendicular to line L through a point that's not on line L. And that's how you do it. And let me just review the process again. Put the point of your compass on the point that's not on the line, and then draw an arc that intersects the line twice. That creates your segment, and that segment is what your line is going to be the perpendicular bisector of. And then you just go ahead and draw from each point A and B in this case, draw your arcs. So you're making the perpendicular bisector of segment AB, which also creates a line perpendicular to line L. So there you have it. That's how you draw a line perpendicular to a given line through a point that is not on the line, which was point P.